Good afternoon, and welcome to all of you people today. Welcome to Salem Lutheran Church, and we're so happy to have the Century Choir here with us today. Thank you all for coming out and joining us here. My name is Carl Lipke, and I'm the director of the Chancel Choir here, the adult choir here. I've been here for a few years and have enjoyed being here affiliated with this church here. I want you to know, all of you, that you're in for a real treat this afternoon. I heard the rehearsal, and I'm just excited to hear the concert today. They're wonderful musicians. Thank you so much. The choir is directed by Dr. Eric Christensen, and I should tell you that I've known Eric for some time now. I first met Eric, if you can believe this, when he was a junior in high school. I was just young then, too. And Eric came down from Moorhead with his choir, and I was teaching at North St. Paul. We had an exchange concert here, and it was a great time to be associated with Eric. Since then, of course, I've been associated with Eric, going to Christensen Choral School during the summers a number of times, and Eric, of course, was always a section leader at that time. Since then, we've been in touch. I was teaching at North St. Paul, and Eric got the job at Stillwater, and we had exchanges there. I make the contest entry, and I'd always have things to do for Eric here. And anyway, I've been associated with a long time with Eric, and I'm just delighted to have him here. Dr. Christensen's choral music education began at home by going to rehearsals and concerts at his father's Concordia Choir. He began his college training at Pacific Lutheran University with Maurice Skornis and finished at Concordia College with Paul Christensen. He received his master's degree in voice performance from Ralph Roberts of Southwestern Louisiana University, and his DMA from the choral music with Doug McEwen at Arizona State University. In addition, he attended a dozen of Paul Christensen's, surprising, right? dozen of Paul Christensen choral schools. He has been teaching posts at high schools and at four colleges as well. Let's give a big welcome to Dr. Christensen and the Century Concert Choir. Thank you.
Geez, I thought I would have to talk a long time here, and they're so efficient, they got to where they're supposed to go long before I got to my microphone. As I was thinking, you know, I spent a kind of a not a very good summer last summer. I had a bulging disc, if any of you had that. It's painful and lays you up for long periods. Plus, I was up north near Itasca Park, breathing smoke. Remember that? Canada was burning, right? There was a big drought, so I was worried constantly that my forest, my beloved forest, would either die or be burned. And so, and here I'm trying to make a program for this choir to work on, and so I think that might have influenced some of my thinking. But this set is pretty straightforward. The next piece is about grace and beauty, which I think is something the world could use and has, if you just look for it. And then a bit of escapism with the Schumann. You know, everybody wants to disappear. And then just a song of praise at the end. Second set is more to the point of what I was thinking about last summer. But anyway.
Difusor. Oh,
Go ahead. While the choir was marching, this second set is quite a varied bunch of poetry reflecting on our times. This first piece, Rockin' Hawk, is by 98% of the choir's opinion a bit interesting. It's very hard-edged, angular, weirdly constructed, but to help you understand it a bit,
about the terrible abuse of Northern Lights and how it must have affected a thorough human being to see this, you know, in his country, Norway, see this phenomenon and how frightening it must have been and abused. And it made me think of last summer, where we had these weird and amazing sunsets because of all the smoke, this terrible abuse. And so that was the genesis of this idea.
Thank you. This next piece, Trees. Pull up, written by a classmate of mine in the Detroit Choir, and handed it to my father in front of the bus on the tour. And he said, that big song in my head. And so this piece was written, and of course, in the Western tour, and we're in desert country, and we're seeing light growing where no light should be able to grow. And the astonishing thing, the resiliency, the hope that nature provides. We're hoping, for instance, this spring that the forest won't be dead from last fall, from last summer crop, for instance. We suspect there will be no fields. And this speaks to that hope.
Two different views of ways of thinking about Thank you. I did not.
things to say. First of all, I'd like to thank Pastor Jackal for allowing us to sing in this great storied church. You know, I've been hearing about this church for many, many years. You know, going back, you know, the high school choirs in this community have been just out of sight good for so going back generations. And this church has been kind of a center of stuff going on here. The Gar Lockrum alumni group has sung here many times. And of course, the person we met at the beginning of the program, Carl Lipke. Now, I want to say this is very near and dear to my heart, and that is public school teaching. And the two guys that in this church that have put this together for us are Carl Lipke and Jack Schlukebeer, both of whom were generational teachers in the public school for just eons. They're each, one's 107 and the other's 123. But you notice, they're both still doing things. Their whole lives, these are two of the best public school teachers in my whole lifetime that I know of. And they're still acting. They're still doing something. You know, they see a need, they do it. And so they say, oh, let's put on a concert for this, you know, backwoods choir called the Century Choir. You know, so thank you so much, you guys, Carl and Jack. Terrific. Thank you. And of course, Carl is right. He was modest. His North High School choir just sang circles around my Moorhead High choir back in 1968. Very interesting choir tour to Chicago in 1968. Some of you actually have lived long enough to understand that Chicago was burning in 1968. Very wholesome for us juniors in high school.
Thank you. Thank you.
transition from Brahms to this.
In it as well. We have a handful of Century students, eight or something, seven or eight now?
Seven.
Seven. the rest are community members. So if you sing, please join us. We have good hours. In the fall, since I don't like to come down from up north during the nice time up there, we start late. We start in October and end early so I can go back there.
I want to meet my mother. the world. Soon I will be done with the troubles of the world. Oh, how to live with God. Soon I will be done with the troubles of the world. The troubles of the world. The troubles of the world. Soon I will be done with the troubles of the world. Oh, how to live with God.
Oh, wow.
This afternoon. Just a quick note here, any donations you'd like to give that as you leave goes directly to Salem. And once again, a big hand to Eric, Dr. Eric Christensen, and the Friends of the Choir.
Water.